Hi and welcome to the session. Let's work out the following question. The question says, a shot fired at a mark in a horizontal plane through the point of projection goes a meter beyond it when the angle of elevation is alpha. When the angle of elevation is beta, it falls b meter short of the mark. Show that the proper elevation to hit the mark is half of sine inverse a sine 2 beta plus a sine 2 alpha divided by alpha plus beta. So now let us see the solution to this question. So let the point A and the point B be the points where the shot fell at distance A and B when projected at angles alpha and beta respectively. Let C is the exact point at a distance R to be hit. Therefore, R plus A is equal to U square sine 2 alpha divided by G. We call this equation 1. R minus B is equal to U square sine 2 beta divided by G. We call this 2. And R is equal to U square sine 2 theta divided by G. We call this 3. Now subtract 2 from 1, we get A plus B is equal to U square upon G into sine alpha minus sine beta. We call this equation 4. Sorry, here we see that this is sine 2 alpha and sine 2 beta. Now divide 1 by 2 and we get R plus A divided by R minus B is equal to sine 2 alpha divided by sine 2 beta. This implies R sine 2 beta plus A sine 2 beta is equal to R sine 2 alpha minus b sine 2 alpha. This we get by cross multiplying this. This implies r into sine 2 alpha minus sine 2 beta is equal to a sine 2 beta plus b sine 2 alpha. Therefore, r is equal to a sine 2 beta plus b sine 2 alpha divided by sine 2 alpha minus sine 2 beta, and we call this 5. Now from equation 3 and equation 5 we get R is equal to u square upon g sine 2 theta, that is same as a sine 2 beta plus b sine 2 alpha divided by sine 2 alpha minus sine 2 beta. We call this 6. Now from 4 and 6 we get a plus b divided by sine 2 alpha minus sine 2 beta into sine 2 theta is equal to a sine 2 beta plus b sine 2 alpha divided by sine 2 alpha minus sine 2 beta. Now we see that sine 2 alpha minus sine 2 beta gets cancelled with sine 2 alpha minus sine 2 beta on the right hand side. This implies sine 2 theta is equal to a sine 2 beta plus b sine 2 alpha divided by a plus b. This implies theta is equal to half of sine inverse a sine 2 beta plus b sine 2 alpha divided by a plus b. So this is our answer to this question, or we can say that this is what we were supposed to prove in this question. So I hope that you understood the solution and enjoyed the session. Have a good day.